and it is also recorded on Zoom. Okay, good PM, no? EA, not pala 108, EA131, correction. EA131 students. So we are on the second part of our load flow analysis. But before we do that, let us go back to what we have discussed last time on the first video of this module series. We discussed the Y matrix, and we discussed also, by the way, the load flow analysis definition, the importance, applications, and then after that we derived some important equations which is based on nodal analysis, and we generalize the Y matrix, okay? And then the Y matrix is has two important parameters: the self admittances, which is the capital YII, and the mutual admittances, which is YIJ, which is equal to negative YIJ na maliit, or smaller letter, which is your series admittance, while your YII, which is your self admittance, that is the summation of all of the admittances connected at bus I. So from that, you can still recall all of those, and then we arrive at this matrix with this equation, of course. So you already know, if I multiply voltage by admittance, the result is current. This is current. Okay. Bus currents is equal to Y matrix, so Y bus times V bus, or the voltage at the nodes, or voltage at buses. Please take note, one important thing from what we have discussed last time: if we formulate the Y bus matrix, we already formulated or modeled the whole power system. So ibig sabihin nito, in other words, okay, this is your overall model of the power system, which is your Y bus or Y bus matrix. Please take note, by the way, we already have discussed the characteristic of the Y bus, which is an n by n matrix, it's also a sparse matrix and also a square matrix as well, or symmetrical matrix. Okay, we can clear all drawings and then move forward to our discussion here, which is the static load flow equation. Now, since we already derived what is Y bus matrix, we will now discuss the powers at buses. Because if you can still recall what we have discussed on the first video of this module, we discussed there that the load flow analysis, the important parameters that you need to compute is the bus power, or the power at buses, or power at lines, etc., or yung tinatawag natin load flow, so power flow. And then from here, we have this equation. Now, guys, ito ha, parehas lang siya dito kung titingnan natin mabuti. If your S is equal to VI conjugate, please take note, voltage and current are vectors. Okay? Which is simply equal to this. Okay? P plus JQ in this case. Now, if mangyayari is VI conjugate ito, and if I want to transfer the conjugate to the voltage, please take note, that is the same. VI conjugate or IV conjugate, they are the same. The only difference is your reference. In this case, if I is my conjugate, V is reference. Otherwise, if V is conjugate, I is reference. So please take note, only the reference changes. Kung sa kahit saan yung conjugate, voltage man ng current, walang problema. At least one parameter on the voltage and current must be conjugate. So if you do that, if I change the conjugate, this one, by conjugate, by multiplying by the conjugate, the result will be, yan, conjugate na lang ito, current vector is the reference, P minus JQ. So this one is the same here. Okay, no harm done on the equation. Okay, now we wherein VI is the voltage conjugate of the I bus, considering the current will be our reference. Okay, considering also as well, no, yung current equation. Please take note that the J here is current. So that is equal to P minus JQI all over VI. Please take note I is the bus number. And thus, no, by applying this one, no, and more expand, or you expand, P minus JQI is simply equal to VI conjugate V1 Y11 V2 Y12 VN YYN. So as you can see, there's a pattern, right? So Y11 muna siya, tapos V21 I2 parang up to the IN. This is I, not 1N. Okay? So from that, no, we can have a pattern, right? So to get the slack power, bus powers, this is the bus powers. The equation is considering again, no, I is equal to 1. Okay, so VI, okay, or V1 na ito, V1 Y11 II plus V2 YI2. So, mangyari dyan, VI conjugate, VI YII plus, no, the summation, no, from 1 to N, right, of VN YIN. Right. Oh, sorry. So, ibig sabihin, no, here, P will not be equal to I from P to N. Equal to okay. So, ibig sabihin yan, no, N here pala will not be equal to dapat hindi mag-equal to sa ayan, tama nga. Dapat yung VI dapat ito. Wait. Not be equal to YIT. Yan. Okay. Okay. So this is the equation here. If you want to get, no, power at the bus, no, or bus power. Okay. So we can have this equation here, which we will discuss later when we go, no, to the other equations involved, no, in terms of SLFE. So there is an algorithm which is dependent if the bus is TQ or PD. We will discuss it later in the next few slides. But anyway, no, we arrive, no, at a pattern, no, yung pattern na sinasabi natin, no. So we can use, no, this equation here below, no, wherein I can be 1 2 3 pero hindi pwedeng mangyari, no, that this is your P, for example, from the counter, hindi pwedeng mag-equal yung P sa I. Why? Because it is already given here, no? Ito kasi yung unang ano, self ito eh. And the others here that you can see here is mutual admittances. Okay, you can use this equation below, no? Okay, now let us go forward to the next few slide. Now there are two important solutions for SLFE, slack load flow equations. So ang static load flow equations, static load flow equations. So yung SLFE or the nonlinear equation has two important solutions. Actually, marami na yung sinabi natin from last meeting. May Gauss Seidel, may Newton Raphson, may fast decoupled, may DC power flow, etc. But anyway, this is the two equations involved, no, for the static load flow equations that we can discuss, no, in this topic. But we will not discuss other solutions dahil masyado ng toxic yun, kung tutuusin. Ang tanging paralang dyan is maintindihan mo yung unang simulation, o yung unang iteration. And then the second, third, fourth, fifth is the same if you involve programming, so, especially MATLAB. Okay, there are bus classifications. So may tinatawag ka na type 1 o load bus. Ang ibig sabihin ng isang load bus is a PQ bus. So meaning to say, no, kung may bus bar ka, no, may bus bar. Pwedeng mangyari, no, na may dalawang element, no, doon sa load mo. Ito 'yung load mo eh. Tapos ito 'yung generation mo. We could say this is a load bus. Pwedeng mangyari na ganito ang setup, may generation at may load, or walang generation pero load lang. Okay? Kaya kung titingnan natin dito, guys, is naka-general, no, yung definition ng isang load bus. We need to know this simply because when you go to the programming side, you need to input if that bus is a PQ bus, a PB bus, or a slack bus. Very, very important. So dito, no, sa isang PQ bus, the bus powers P and Q, no? Since PD and QD are known at a given load, and PG and QG are the specified, kasi still recall last meeting, di ba, meron kang apparent power dyan, PG, QG, at meron kang load PD plus JQD. Right? So, ibig sabihin sa isang PQ bus, to generalize, yung given, pwedeng PG, QG, pwedeng PD, QD, no? From here, no, yan ang given. Ang magiging result ng iteration, kasi mag-iterate ka eh. Magsosolve ka ng mga ng static load for equations. So from there, it will give these results, no? The equation of the solution of the SLFE or static load for equation will give us. Ang ibig sabihin ng dalawang bar na ganyan, magnitude ng voltage sa angle. So, ibig sabihin, if I have given a PQ bus, the result no, will be ng solution ng load flow, ang ibibigay sa iyo is the voltage at saka yung alpha. Yung alpha is the bus angle. Please take note, no? Ito, may voltage yan at saka may bar angle. So, kapag given ang S, ang PG, QG, PD, at saka QD, from there, no, by simulation or iterative technique, you can get the voltage at saka yung angle ng bar. Ngayon, meron kang tinatawag naman na ibang bus din, no? Which is ito naman ang tinatawag na voltage control bus. May mga ganitong buses na kailangan i-limit yung voltage. It must be limit into a certain value. Okay? So, ang tawag doon is a voltage control or a PB bus, no? Wherein, ang setup niya is ganito, no? So, yan, may bus bar ka rito. May generation ka dyan. Tapos, yung voltage mo dyan sa bus bar, V-limit. Eh sabihin natin 1.05 per unit. Hindi pwedeng, no, na lumagpas o lumiit diyan basta ang voltage limit niya eh 1.05. Kunyari ang machine mo is 4 kilovolt, no, yung motor mo. No, ito yung load mo. Kunyari ang motor mo ay 4 kilovolt ang kaya. Kaso nga lang yung generation mo is 4.16 kilovolt. So may mga ganyan na galing sa substation. Ang kailangan is 4 kilovolt lang. Kaya nga voltage, dapat i-maintain niya yung voltage doon to 4 kilovolt. May mga ganitong setup ha. Minsan, hindi lang siya 1.05. Minsan, mababa pa nga. Ang limit niya ay 0.97. For example, pwedeng ganyan ano, per unit. It depends kung ano ang kukontrolin niya na voltage. Kailangan, ang boost, ang kailangan lang niya no, na voltage is ganito lang kalaki. Ganun lang kalaki ilalagay niya. Hindi pwede lumagpas o bumangos doon. Kaya nga tawag sa kanya, is a voltage control bus or PD bus. Unlike from the PQ bus, whatever the voltage is, okay lang. Kasi there's no limitations. Kaya kung titingnan natin mabuti, there are some circumstances na kailangan mo ng Q limit, di ba? Which is, kung naaalala nyo, may minimum maximum, I don't know kung nagagawa nyo ito sa design. Kunyari, 0.8 to negative 0.8 to positive 0.8. May mga nakikita kayong ganito ano, sa mga simulations sa ETAP, yung tinatawag natin Q limits. Okay. So from there, ang ibig sabihin lang po niyan, kailangan nandun ka lang sa limit niyan. Hindi pwede mag-pass, hindi pwede mawawas. So, what will be no the treatment on this kind of bus, no? So PB bus. So nakalagay naman, no? The given at this bus PD and QD is given. At saka yung voltage magnitude at saka yung PG given, no? Ang kukontrolin mo kapag V limit, by the way. Kapag kinokontrol mo V limit, ang kinokontrol mo is the value of the reactive power. So if you can still recall your machines, 'di ba? Lalong-lalo na doon sa ano, sa pagkontrol ng field winding, 'di ba? Pag kinokontrol mo yung field winding, nakokontrol mo yung reactive power, nakokontrol mo yung voltage. So ganito din 'yan. If you alter Q, you can alter the magnet the direction of the voltage. Kasi guys, di ba may V alpha ito? So what I'm considering is the, eto pala, no? That direction. If you control the reactive power, you control also the direction of the voltage at the bus. Kaya lalabas dito, no? Yung magiging result is yung magiging value ngayon ng QG at saka yung bar angle. Yan ang magiging result niya. Which is very, very important dahil ang etong bar angle na to, yung voltage angle ito, we're considering the voltage angle. So you can feel this one when you are in, when you're doing the programming, you steadily compute parameters. So, doon mo lang ma-feel yung mga yan. Huh? And the last one that nalis is the slack bus. Ang tawag din dito, guys, is the reference bus. So, in this kind of reference bus or the so-called slack bus is yung given, okay, known lagi yan, huh? So, PD, given, QD, at saka yung, ito, forever na yung value nito. So, this one is constant. There are some times, no, na yung tinatawag nating reference o slack bus, ang V bar alpha lagi nito is 1 bar 0, if not given. Okay, 1 bar 0. So, pag nakita mo na ang angle, eh, bar 0, dun sa bus bar na yun, yun yung reference bus. Please take note. If you have a load flow algorithm, you cannot continue without any reference. If you can still recall, no, our balanced polyphase system. Di ba, you cannot compute anything without a reference. Kaya we always, no, make sure that we have the reference VAM, no, for a balanced polyphase. Pag nag-unbalance siya, ang ginagawa nating reference is VAB. Instead, unless stated, rather. Unless stated. So dito, talagang walang ibibigay sa'yo. Dahil you will be the one who will assume the slack bus. Please take note, the slack bus as well here, no, yung may pinaka-highest voltage rating. Yan ang ginagawang assumption, no, doon sa power system. Kunyari, have 14 bus. Minsan ang ginagawa mong reference bus is yung utility, right? Because yun yung pinaka-high, eh, yun yung papunta sa grid. At least one reference will do. You cannot do two references or two slack buses. Only one. And ang binibigyan ng importer, so ina-assume natin lagi, yung may pinakamataas na voltage rating, no, doon sa system. So please take note of this when you go to the programming, and then when you go, no, on your researches. So may mga nagre-research dito, tapos kailangan nila ng load flow. Please take note, no, the you need to have at least a slack bus, but only one. Okay, we can clear all drawing, and then we can move forward. Okay, now on the next few slides, no, I will skip, no, this approximate load flow study, kasi ang gagawin naman natin hindi approximation, but we will use, no, the na full Newton-Raphson or full Gauss Seidel techniques, because this approximate load flow study, if you want to have a faster algo, but again, what we need is the complete solution without any errors, right? So now I just presented it here, no, for others who want to use the approximate load flow study, but we will skip this, no, on the on our discussion, no. Basically, no, may mga tinitreat ka lang dyan na mga angle, no, na para ma-simplify yung solution, yung assumptions. Pero hindi kasi lagi ganyan yung assumption. Eh. We need to have, no, the overall data to prevent any errors. Okay? So, mas maganda, pumunta na tayo talaga, no, doon sa ginagamit, yung typical na ginagamit. We can use the Gauss Seidel method, the full Gauss Seidel method, Gauss Seidel method, and we can use as well Newton-Raphson. Okay, na Gauss Seidel method, we progressively compute, no, for the estimate, no, of a known quantity. Minsan, guys, kaya ang ginagawa dito eh, diba? Ito, oh. Most method of successive substitution, diba? So, ibig sabihin ng method of successive substitution, you have a assumed value, and then from that assumed value, kung hindi nakuha yung termination, no, value, which is the EK, ek-ek ang tawag ko rito. So I don't know kung ano termination value ninyo sa inyong inyong numerical methods, but we usually use the 1 times the negative 5. So hangga't hindi nakukuha yung termination value, no, we cannot stop. But there are sometimes, no, kapag ginamit mo yung Gauss Seidel method, napakadami ng iteration, hindi pa rin nag hindi pa rin nagco-converge, right? Nagda-diverge pa siya, lumalayo yung data. Ang nangyayari diyan is, no, napakalaki siguro ng unbalancing ng generation sa volt, sa loading mo. So, kailangan talaga mag-equal yung generation sa kayong load mo eh. But anyway, no, ang Gauss Seidel method, hindi naman natin kukunin lahat ng iteration. Kunyari, you want to get, no, the voltage at a certain bus, then from there, lumabot ng 20 iterations. Hindi kita pa 20 iterations. No? Napakadami na nun. Siguro mga 4 or 5 iterations will do. Okay? For this purpose. Kaya nangyayari dyan, guys, no, yung Gauss Seidel method, although pare-parehas lang ang nangyayari, pwede mong gawin sa computer, pwede mong gawin sa Excel, no? Ang nangyayari, eh, mas mahirap talaga pag minamano-mano. Tapos, ang dami pang iterations. Hindi katulad ng nag-Newton-Raphson ka, mabilis pa sa alas 4, no? So, mabilis yung iteration niya yung pagko-converge. So, yun talaga yung objective man. No? But anyway, guys, no, ano ba talaga yung Gauss Seidel method? Progressively compute for the more accurate estimate of a known quantity until the results obtained give a desired degree of accuracy. And under these conditions, the solution will be convergent. So, syempre, I will not go to details anymore because this is already from the numerical method. If you consider a system of n nonlinear equations in this form with a function in terms of x, you can start, no, the assumed values of x. I, which is written as x10, so ibig sabihin, yung x10, x20, bibigyan ka ng assumption. O ikaw magbibigay ng number. No? So from there, no, from the first approximation, you can now get the first iteration in terms of a function of the initial variable. And then from there, pag nakuha mo na yung first iteration, substitute mo naman dun sa second, no? Sa second naman na iteration, tapos may nakuha ka na naman, kukunin mo na naman yung difference hanggat makuha mo yung degree of accuracy o yung termination, di ba? Value. Now, dito, ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyong termination value. So, yung previous mo, i-minus mo dun sa, yung new value mo, minus mo dun sa previous, yan ang magiging epsilon mo o yung tinatawag nating termination value. Okay. Now, we can have an example. So, to give you an insight, solve for the value of x in this equation, 2 minus sine x is equal to 0. And we will use the Gauss Seidel method and use an error tolerance of 0.00001. Or, yan nga po, no? Ganun ang gagawin natin. Mag-assume muna tayo ng value. No? If x 0 is 0, we can assume no a value of 0. Then substitute natin sa 2 sa 2 minus sine x. So lalabas is 2. 2 minus 0 ay hindi umabot doon sa epsilon. So another iteration ulit. So from here, no, if x is equal to 2, so sa second iteration, substitute mo doon sa x yung 2 minus sine x, which is x is 2. So lumabas is 1.09. 1.09 minus 2 is not 0.0001. So another iteration na naman. Until you reach 13 iterations. So kung papansin ninyo, ang problem ng Gauss Seidel is the memory allocation. Diba? Kasi habang lumalaki ang equation mo, tapos ang dami mong substitution, syempre, yung memory allocation mo sa computer mo, lumababa o nagiging mabagal. Pero ngayon, sa sobrang taas na ngayon ng memory capacity ng inyong mga CPU, ay pwedeng-pwede na ito. Lalo-lalo na meron ka na software na MATLAB. No? Okay, for this, ang pinakamahalaga dito is yung x13 mo, yung minus x12, nagtugma na doon sa epsilon. And thus, the final answer for this iteration or example is 1.10606. Okay? Now, let us move forward to another no, example wherein we will use a Gauss Seidel method and we need to find the root no, using this non-linear. So, papansin nyo, pwede rin ang Gauss Seidel sa isang non-linear equation. And we will use an error tolerance as stated above, no? Yung stated dun sa problem number 1, no? So we have the function of x cubed minus 6x squared plus 9x minus 4, which is equal to 0. Okay, now ang gagawin mo muna is kunin mo lang yung isang, you need to get one value of x. Then from here, we can isolate x, one value only, and then, no, and then transfer the other terms no to the right side so that you can have an equation of x only. So what will happen is g of x na siya. So naging result is negative 19 x cubed plus 6 all over 9 times x squared plus 4 all over 9. Okay. So we have no an initial value of 2. So what you will do is substitute 2 doon sa function ng g of x. So what will happen is 2.22 magiging result. 2.22 minus 2, no, ay hindi pa rin siya umabot doon sa error tolerance. So substitute 2.2222 doon sa g of x. So ang lalabas is 2.5173. No? 2.5173, you subtract it by 2.2222, hindi pa rin naabot sa error tolerance. Until you achieve a value of 4 in 8 iterations. So, ibig sabihin, 8 iterations ang nangyari. Okay? So, you will be surprised sa Newton-Raphson, magiging 3 lang yan, no? 4. So, mas mabilis kasi yung iteration method sa Newton-Raphson. No? So, you already know that no on your basic numerical method. Okay, now, if you want to improve the convergence, okay, we can have no yung tinatawag nating acceleration factor. Ayan, so siguro hindi na-i-discuss sa inyo ito, no? Sa inyong numerical methods. Ang tawag ko dyan is yung alpha. Your alpha can have a range no, of 0.3 to 0.6. Yung typical na ginagamit no? F.4, kalagitnaan, pero pare-pareho lang yan, no? Yung acceleration factor. Ay, by the way, I forgot to mention. Hindi pala, yung increase pala yung nasabi ko, dapat may 1 point something. So, it must be, no? Sorry, ang ano nito yung 1.2 to 1.6. So, yung typical, no? 1.3 or 1.4. Ayan. So, your acceleration factor can have that range, no? And then, the typical value can be 1.3 or 1.4. The equation will be this one, no? So, this is your x acceleration. Ang tawag dyan, x acceleration value. And then, as you can see here, no, yung x to the k is the new value. Okay? So, papasin nyo naman dun sa ano eh, dun sa naging result natin later. X new plus whatever your alpha. And then, your x old. X new pala. Sorry. So, x new minus x old. By the way, it must be x old. Okay. That will be your acceleration factor. So, itong x old, ito yung previous iteration. Ito, syempre, yung new iteration, x old previous. Okay, we can have an example, no? For the example, no, doon sa number 2, we use an acceleration factor 1.25. If we use 0, no, doon sa initial value, the answer is 2. Ah, by the way, rather, this is the first assumed value. If we assume, no, that this, yung 2 kanina, no, yung value ng 2, substitute natin sa g of x, so, yung first iteration natin is 2.2222. So, ito yung yung previous na assumption mo, no? Kanyari, number 2 ka na. So, yung old na sinasabi, yung preceding iteration o yung old iteration. So, gamitin natin yung equation, no, ng x acceleration, no, for the first iteration. So, 2 siya, yes, yung old, plus 1.25 yung alpha. Yung x new 2.22 minus 2. Okay, the answer is 2.2778. Ngayon, saan mo ima-minus ito, no? Siyempre, yung epsilon natin. Dapat, ang nakuha natin x acceleration minus ng x old. So, 2.778 minus 2. So, hindi pa rin siya umabot. So, lalabas na naman ulit ito. 2.2778, i-substitute mo sa g of x. Answer is 2.59. So, use, no? The rate of convergence formula natin para makuha yung acceleration. So, x acceleration is 2.778, which is the old, plus 1.25, new 2.59 minus 2.2278. The answer is 2.66. 2.66 minus 2.27, hindi pa rin siya nag-tolerance, no, dun sa value natin. So, ala natin 1 times 10 to the negative 5. So, after, no, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 iterations, so lumabas is 4. So bumaba lang siya ng konti, no? Pero may improvement. If you want to have a more faster, you can use a higher level, hanggang 1.6 lang, no? So kung 1.25 yan, 1.3, 1.35, 1.4, no problem. Parang booster lang tawag mo dyan, eh. Binuboost mo lang, eh, no? Yung iteration natin eh. So, para maging mabilis. But anyway, yet it will yield with the same answer. Okay. Let us move forward to Newton-Raphson. Well, yung Newton-Raphson natin, so medyo may alam na kayo dito. Kaya ang mahalaga nang naman is ma-refresh ko. Parang refresher na lang naman din ito eh. So, if you want to consider a solution of a one-dimensional equation, f of x is constant, magdi-derivative ka nga lang, di ba? So, ang pinakamahalaga dito, no, yung tinatawag nating error, no? Tapos ito, yung delta C natin. Okay? So, may example naman tayo, no? Para mas maliwanagan eh. Okay? Okay, we can have this example here. Ah, by the way, another form of equation. So, I will give, no, the review dito sa ate, sa inyo, no? But ang importante is itong mga equation na ito, no? Ayan. Tapos, we can now get the J of K by having the differential of the function. So, paulit-ulit lang naman yan, yan din. Paulit-ulit. Okay? So, let us have an example para ma-ano natin, mas ma-bigyan natin ng application. Okay, for example, with the same equation a while ago, x cubed minus 6x squared plus 9x minus 4. Now, we can assume a value, no? So, kanina x 0 natin, 2 yata, no? 2. Now, will become x 0, which is the first assumption is equal to 6. So, substitute mo yan, no? Doon sa equation sa taas. And then, after you substitute, you need to, no? Differentiate the function. Okay? So, ayan na po yung ano, lalabas. By the way, differentiate mo muna. So, we can assume muna ito. Ayan ang gagawin natin later, no? Dun sa delta C. So, ang mangyayari, tama nga, 3x squared minus 12x plus 9 kay constant 0. Yes, that's the first differential. Now, delta C, which is C minus f of x, substitute. So, you substitute 6 to this. So, it will yield with this answer. Negative 50. Okay? So, you can now get the differential of x, differential of the function in terms of x. So, lalabas is ito, no? 3, substitute mo 6 dito. 3, 6 squared minus 12, 6 plus 9, 45. So, ang lalabas sa root, no, if we divide delta C by df all over dx at the zero iteration, no, or initial, rather, lalabas negative 1.1111. So, the value of x, no, is simply equal to 4.88889. So, ang kailangan dito, guys, no, eh, yung 4.889, yung epsilon natin, 4.889 minus mo ng 6, eh, hindi equal sa epsilon. So, you will do the same pattern, no, on the other iteration. So, if you do that, it will become like this. No, ayan, lalabas. Doon sa succeeding iteration. So, lalabas x2, 4.27, x3, 4.04, x4, 4.001, at x5, 4. So, lalabas sa x6, ganun din, 4 din, kaya ang epsilon na satisfied. So, the answer is 4. And then, you have only 5 or 6 iterations, which is compared to an 8 iteration doon sa ating Gauss Seidel method. Okay, so there's an improvement. Okay. Now, let us move forward now, no, to this equation. So, kung naalala nyo rin kanina, no, we have an equation. Ito, looks pam sa atin kanina ito. It is a looks pam equation. So, ito yung equation kanina, no, na ginawa natin. Okay? Doon sa SLFT, the start of this video. That we can now get, no, the load bus powers. So, case number one, lahat PQ bus. All buses are PQ bus or a PQ bus. So, we discussed also what is PQ bus a while ago, no? So, we have, no, the load bus powers having this equation that we have a while ago. So, yung equation natin na VI, no, conjugate, tapos yung may summation kanina, no, na P is not equal to I, considering P will start at 1, counter, YIP, VP, di ba? Equality sign to PI minus JQI. Okay, now, that's the bus power. Okay, may pattern yan. Huwag po kayong mag-alala. When we go to the application or problem solving, you can observe that. Now, it's very important, no, that to get the bus power, okay, at every bus. So, equation number 2 is another important equation. Actually, sa Gauss Seidel method, dalawa lang ang minememorize ko na solution dyan. Yung etong sinabi ko kanina, eto at saka to. The others are more on circuitry, more on nodal, KCL, wala na mahirap dapat, no? But I usually use that equation number 2, ito, no? At saka itong equation number 1 for the bus powers. Kasi yan naman ang mahalaga, di ba? When you want to get load flow in a load flow analysis, the bus powers, and then after you get the bus powers, you can get the currents. After the bus powers, you can get, no, the voltages per bus or node voltages or bus voltages. Okay, that equation number 2 and equation number 1 is very important. The others, for the PQ bus, hindi na natin kakailanganin talaga. Kasi itong number 3 na ito, no, equation 3 na ito eh. Sorry for that. This is equation 3. This equation, no, if you want to get a specific value of voltage at a specific iteration. Kunyari, no, you have 20 iterations before you obtain the answer. You want to get, no, the voltage at the 17th iteration. So you can use this equation. But we will not discuss this one, no, because if I have machine problems, pwede, pero hindi na. Ang mahalaga dito, guys, is you know how to compute it manually. If you know how to compute it manually, you can program it on your own. Okay, we can now go forward to the iteration process for case number 1 of PQ bus. So mag-assume ka muna ng value, as we have discussed, no, from the previous slides, no, on Newton-Raphson and Gauss Seidel, you need to assume values for V2, V3, up to the V to the N. Bakit po yung V1 nasaan? Kasi V1, in-assume mo na agad na slack bus. If this is will be the case, otherwise stated. So, ibig sabihin, V1 na agad is 1 bar 0. No? Yung V1 is lagi pong gagawin natin slack bus. Dapat ang iteration is ascending. Hindi pwede V1, tas pupunta agad, no? Kunyari, you have 14 buses. V1, kung gusto mo na agad punta sa V14, hindi pwede. Dapat ang pagko-compute, no, is a step-by-step procedure, no, V1, V2, V3, V4, etc. If V1 is the slack bus, well, this is a forever value. Meron din forever din sa load flow. Yung slack bus, kasi lagi ng value niyan is constant na. Yan yung constant mo. Kasi may voltage ka na na-given, meron ka ng reference bus. So, therefore, yun agad yung value, no, yung slack bus. No, 1 bar 0. And then from there, you can use MOS, method of successive substitution, o yung tinatawag natin Gauss Seidel method. No? So, yan na yung pagsasubstitute using equation number 2. So, mas maganda na pag meron po tayong, ano, meron tayong example. And we use an error tolerance again of 0.00001 unless stated on the problem. Okay, then after this, we can now use the iterative techniques until, no, you solve the magnitude and the change of bus voltages until it reaches, no, the tolerance level. Now, after knowing V1, V2, V3, no, we can use, no, the equation to get, no, the slack bus equation. No, ito po yung slack bus equation of power as slack bus. Ibig sabihin, yung I kanina doon sa equation number 1, ginawa natin 1. So, from here, no, if you want to use the format of VI conjugate, no, gawin mong positive ang Q by multiplying, no, the Q by negative. Right? Kunyari, lumabas dito is 5. Kunyari lang po ito, no, 0.5 minus J.2. Ang nangyari, ito yung P1 mo, ito Q1. Kung gusto mong gawing VI conjugate niyan, i-conjugate mo lang ito. So, kaya kung mumultiply ng negative 1, kasi i-conjugate mo yung negative to positive, right? By multiplied by negative as well, it will become positive. Because this form is a V conjugate I form. Ito, VI conjugate. No problem. Because katulad na sinabi ko sa inyo kanina, before we start, no, from the first few slides, no, that the conjugate is just for reference purpose only. Okay? Then the others here, as you can see guys, no, yung pagko-compute po ng tinatawag nating current, no, from bus I to J. Now, una, lagay lang natin dito, no, pag sinabi mong I from J to, kunyari, bus I, bus J, you want to get I, J, you can use this relationship. Yung I, sir, dito, series current. I siya, ang tawag naman, doon sa ISH. Now, guys, this is purely what we have discussed on the first slide, di ba? Yung tinatawag ho natin current is equal to V high minus V low. You multiply it by admittance, right? So, this is V high. So, ganun din yan, no? So, VI minus VJ, kasi pag ganun yung current mo, no? VI minus VJ times YIJ. YIJ is series admittance, by the way. I need to have this in a smaller form. Yan, YIJ. So, YIJ, please take notes, is series admittance. Okay? So, makukuha mo na agad yan, no? Tapos, syempre, nodal ang ginamit dito. So, parang nangyari, nodal analysis, di ba? VI, why shunt I? And if you multiply, no, the bus voltage by IJ, the answer is SIJ. Okay? So, you can have this equation number 5, no? So, in-expand lang ito. But, ito lang naman gagawin mo dyan eh. Because if VI is already solved, no? So, nasolve mo na yung VI, masosolve mo na rin yung SIJ. If you already have IIJ. Because yung VI saka VJ is already defined. Or it's being solved, no? From the load flow analysis. And then, you can now get S losses. S losses is SIJ plus SJI. Please take note, guys, from our previous discussion, SIJ will not be equal to SJI if and only if, no? This will be equal. Okay. S up. Sorry, na naman. It must be SIJ. SIJ is equal to SJI if and only if, no, your Y shunt are equal. Equal lahat sila sa lahat ng line. If Y shunts are not equal to all lines, SIJ is not equal to SJI. Please take note of this. Mangyayari lang ito if equal yung shunt admittance natin kung nakapay sa lahat, no, ng transmission line. Pag hindi po sila equal, no, di rin equal ang apparent powers. Kaya kung titingnan natin mabuti, no, SIJ plus SJI, which is the kasalungat, di ba? Yung opposite niya is simply equal to the losses at that line. And if you have, no, the acceleration factor, we can use, no, the equation as well to get the voltage. Kasi yung kanina in terms of a value of x, ngayon ganun din, v old plus acceleration factor, v old minus v new, right? So as I mentioned, the acceleration factor is from 1.2 to 1.6. Anywhere from that range, no, maximum is 1.6. Okay, I think I will discuss, no, the PV bus, no, and some examples on our next meeting. Okay, para hindi naman masyadong pressure, no? So that will be enough, no, for today's discussion. We can stop the recording.